sacrifice and what he did on the cross for us. Okay, so I really think that we need to get a little background. We need to refresh our memories a little bit, okay? So it was the will of the Lord that he would send his only son down to earth to perform miracles and to help people. But then at the end of his life, he died on a cross for us. And he didn't have to. We didn't deserve it because we as humans are filthy, right? We sin. We do things that are wrong and against God. But he loved us so much that he went on a cross and he shed his blood for us. And the Bible tells us that by his wounds, we are healed. So what that means is because his blood was shed for us, we no longer have to bow down to sin. Because we have victory over that through Jesus, through his blood. And we're talking about our verse, right? We're talking about overcoming through the blood of Christ. It's all about the blood. It all starts. Everything you do when you kneel down at an altar and you're asking for forgiveness, it all leads back to the cross. Okay? So now we're going to talk about three things. Three things that we all do wrong. And it's going to be lying. It's going to be disobedience. And it's going to be our attitudes. Okay, there's many sins out there, but these are the things we're going to focus on. Okay, so lying. Lying as in, you told your mom that you cleaned your room, but you didn't. Or you said you cleaned up that mess, but you didn't. Or you said you didn't make that mess, but you really did. Okay, now let's see why this is wrong. The Bible tells us that everything that comes out of our mouth should be truthful and not deceitful. Deceitful is of lies. Okay, we shouldn't be lying because it's against God. Now let's look at disobedience. Disobedience, the Bible tells us that we need to respect, we need to honor, and we need to obey our parents. And that's a huge responsibility, right? Right? God gives us a huge responsibility to respect and honor and obey our parents. And this, there's hope in this. There's hope at the end of this, okay? Now the last one, this is a big one. Our attitude, especially towards our parents, our siblings, and people that care about us, our attitude. You know, sometimes life can seem like a roller coaster, right? Okay, so you wake up, you're feeling like you're on top of the world, you're having such a great day, you're in the best mood. You go downstairs, you're making yourself a bowl of cereal, you're so ready for this bowl of cereal. You already put the cereal in the bowl, and you go to look in the fridge, and there's no milk. Boom. Your day's not good. You're just in the worst mood. I know I'm good. And then then your mom says that you can go outside and you can play on this sunshine, beautiful day, and you're like, woohoo, this is awesome. I get to go play outside. But you're only out there for 5 minutes and then it begins to rain. Your day's done. Right? So life can feel like that sometimes. We become sad, we become angry. But it's one thing that we know, God wants us to find the joy in every single situation. Okay, not to look at the bad things, but to focus on the good things. And we certainly know that God doesn't want us to go take our anger out on our parents, out on our siblings, the people that love us, anyone who has authority over us, right? So let's jump back to this amazing love story where Jesus died on the cross for us. And this is huge. I mean, Jesus loves you. It's incredible. I couldn't even explain it. We don't know how much Jesus loves us. We'll never understand it. But let's jump back to this. We talked about the blood. It's all in the blood, okay? And then how when we kneel at the altars and we know that we've done wrong, we ask Jesus to cleanse us in this blood to wash away our sin. And we have to realize that we don't have to lie, and we don't have to disobey, and we don't have to have a bad attitude even though that we want to because of what Jesus did on the cross. And and I really encourage you young people to get a hold of God at a young age. Because I didn't do that. And because of that, I had a lot of regret. And a lot of sadness that came from God. And if I would have found God at a young age, I would have saved myself. For anything that happened now, I'm over that. But, you know, I'm thankful for what happened. I have the Lord now. I'm safe. But before we do altar call, I want to talk to them about prayer and worship. God, I need less of me, and I need more of you. And this is why you raised your hand. God, I need you. I really need you in my life. And that's why we raise our hands. Because it's a complete surrender. We worship the Lord. So I encourage you, we're about to do altar call. I know somebody wants to come to the music. We're about to do altar call. And boys will come over here, girls will come over here like yesterday. And I encourage you guys to pray, to seek the Lord. And I know sometimes as young kids, you're gonna feel ashamed, you're gonna feel embarrassed, you're gonna feel uncomfortable. But you don't need to. Because you can look to Jesus as a best friend, right? But also somebody who died on the cross for you. So you have